viewers, I welcome you all to Trinity English Joseph. Today, we are going to discuss about narrative. I already discussed it to you about story writing. Today, we are going to discuss about narrative. This narrative and other writing skills are useful to all the students. It's not only for 10th. It is useful for all the students. So please subscribe to my channel. Like, share and comment and pass on to all your friends, relatives and whomsoever is in requirement of writing skills. Please pass to them so that all will benefit from my videos. Now let us enter into the topic narrative. Generally, a narrative is a sequence of fictional and non-fictional events. Fictional is which is not real, which is imagined. Whereas non-fictional means facts or reality. So when you talk about the sequence of these fictional and non-fictional events, the moment you say narrative, it is all in one particular sequence. It is in chronological order, one after the other. Whenever there is an order, we call it as a narrative. And here, it is a way of presenting connected events in order to tell a good story. So here, whenever you want to present a good story, it is a connected events. One and the other event, they are completely connected one after the other. So that's why, as I told you, it is a sequence of events. So they are sequenced already. Now here, some examples are here. A narrative essay, a biography, an autobiography. And then we have a novel. We have accidents, incidents, events. So all these kind of things, they come under narrative. And a narrative is synonymous with a story. Here, now along with the story, this is almost like a synonym. Okay, same kind of meaning that a narrative has. And here, when writing a narrative, authors make the decision of which events to relate and in what order to relate them. Here, when they relate the events, what are the events to be related? In what order they are supposed to be related? How they are supposed to be related? All those things they are said here according to the author's will and wish. So whatever they wish for, whatever they want to do for, so they continue doing it in the way whatever they want to. So that is what a narrative, and in whichever way they want, they narrate it. Next, what are the features of a narrative? What are the different things are there in the narrative? So first one is plot. In the plot, it is the thread of events that occur in a story. How the events are sequenced. As I told you, narrative is a sequence of events. How they are sequenced one after the other. How they are supposed to be brought together. How they are supposed to be connected. That connectivity is known to be as a plot. And next is setting. Setting is the location of events in time and place. So how a location is being referred to, okay, in what place and in which time, whatever it was there, that we call it as setting. And the third one is characters. Characters are the people or the animals or the things, whatever it may be. So in the story, who drive the plot? So the characters, they take the plot forward. And here, as I already told you in my story writing, we have two types of characters, major characters and minor characters. See here, next one is the conflict. The conflict is the problem. So here in the narrative, what is the problem that was there and how that was being resolved? So that is what we take care in the narrative. Next, the theme. See here, the theme is the one, what does exactly the writer intend the reader to understand? So in what way he wanted to understand the order and the way in which the author want the reader to understand, that we call it as the theme. Next, we call it as point of view. So point of view is the one, the perspective from which the author or the writer views the story. So here, that's what we call it as a point of view. Next, we call the structure. Structure is the general order in which way that is arranged, how the narrative is arranged. So we have a beginning, middle and end. So here we have these are the features. And next, we would be viewing what are the types of narrative. Types of narrative. Now we have four types of narratives. First one is linear narrative. In the linear narrative, the writer presents the events in the order which they actually happened. So the narrator or the writer continues the events or actions which they have continued according to the order. And it completely follows on chronological order. Without the order, it doesn't take place. So thus, the linear narrative takes place in the chronological order. And the next one is non-linear narrative. So the non-linear narratives presents the events out of order. And especially, the writer or the narrator employs flashbacks. So he brings in flashback in between. If you watch certain movies, if you read certain novels, if you watch certain serials, you see there the flashbacks are brought in. And the writer goes out of track, out of box, and then brings in so many narratives or flashbacks into it. So this is, we call it as a non-linear narratives. And here he uses other literary devices to shift the chronology of a story or to shift the narrative of a writing. And then here the third one is quest narrative. See here, generally if a writer, if the protagonist or the main character whomsoever works tirelessly towards the goal of that particular person, that we call it as quest narrative. And here in the quest narrative, the main character of the narrative faces a lot of obstacles on their way of achievement. So when the main character faces a lot of obstacles on their achievement of their goal or aim, so we call it as quest narrative. And we present the quest narrative with lot of difficulties or trials, tribulations of the main character. And next, we call it as a viewpoint narrative. It is to view from the viewpoint of one particular character. And it is designed mainly to express the points of view or subjective of personal experience of the main character. So here, from the viewpoint of the main character, whatever we view, that we call it as viewpoint narrative. So these are all the different types of narratives. And now, here, this is the way of writing the narrative. If you really like my video, please subscribe to my channel. Like, share to your friends and all those who really love to learn how to write a narrative. So, keep in touch with me and my channel. Hope to see you in the next video with some more updates. Thank you, one and all.